So I've been doing test coils for a little while now. I'll start off with the old jar capacitors. It was cheap, it works. But then I decided I was going to go on to MMCs. So I bought myself a load of capacitors, and then I realised that I was going to make different coils. I started making up modules to go with those coils and in different formats. I was going to do it in a little square panel with the capacitors hot glued on top of that. Unfortunately, when you sort of move them about a bit, they get put in drawers and taken out again. They tend to get knocked about a bit, and the capacitors come off of the backboard. So I decided to make up a module. Essentially, it is a box with two terminals on the end that hold the capacitors inside to make it a bit more rigid. And that seemed to work. But that was with the obit, which was 11 kV at 18 milliamps. Now, I've always wanted to boost up the current at least, and build some bigger coils. I struggled on for quite a while with the obit. And then my friend Steve Lane bought me a NST, which I thank him for. And this needed obviously a different configuration of capacitors, so the block that I made up wasn't right. So I decided to improve on that, and I went for this sort of block, which are basically three lines of capacitors. These are all 0.1 microfarad at 1.5K. And what I've done is actually marked it on the side so that I know what the value is and the voltage. And that's simple with a stencil and a Sharpie. At some point I'll get some more varnish, and I'll do a complete varnish coat on this. The way that the capacitor blocks are made, this is done with MDF. You can use other wood. This is just a piece of MDF I had left over from a project I did with my desk. A bit of a modification there. And I thought, well, I might as well use it on doing these. And the end cheeks, I thought about using a thick piece of Persex on the end, but I'm running a bit short of that. So I've got some thin Persex or acrylic or whatever it is. This is essentially from some old picture frames, so it's quite flexible. And I've actually used two sheets bonded together, which is, you know, it's firm enough for what it is. It's not going to break easily. And then two M6 6mm bolts in the end. They're a bit on the long side, but they do the job. And the idea of the bolts is I can make up some leads with ring terminals on the end, and I can mix and match them. Now, I had to think about at some point I want to do an RSG. So I wanted an extra two banks of capacitors. Now, these are all 12 in a line to give me the 18 kV and the value. So that's fine. And yeah, I've now got a chance I can do static gap or the two together to do rotary gap. And then my friend Steve and another friend Bruce got together, and they bought me another NST, exactly matching. These are actually 10 kV at 50 milliamp. So now I want to think about doing another capacitor bank for static gap. So now I've got two banks, so that's one bank for each transformer essentially, but obviously they'll all be in parallel. So that gives me 50 nanofarads at 18 kilovolts. 10 kb, 18 kb is it's big enough margin for what I want to do. I don't run them very long, and this, it's within the spec. Ideally, I would like to have gone up to 20 kb, but that would mean more bank capacitors and hence more cost. Now, I want to run the two NSTs on an RSG, then that little extra is not really going to cut it. So that's another bank. So basically what you've got is a large and a small for each transformer. They're all paralleled up together. So that will now give me enough capacity for making an RSG, which the plans are on the block, but I'm just waiting for them to be modified, but I'm not sure if that's going to work out. I'm hoping so. There's a little issue with it. So there we go, two transformers and a large set of 120 capacitors, 0.1 microfarads at 1 kb each to give me the I think there's the 80 odd nanofarads that I need for the RSG if it works out.